Hello and welcome to the 11 o'clock news from Bahrain International. I'm Sarah Al-Fatih. His Majesty King Hamad bin Isa Al Khalifa received today at Sakhir Palace the President of the Arab League's Arab Tourism Organization, the ATO, and members of the Higher Coordinating Committee for Joint Arab Action, Bender bin Fahd Al Fahid, and a number of officials at the organization. The President of the ATO presented His Majesty with the Arab Tourism First Degree Medal, which is the highest medal awarded to kings and presidents. The medal was awarded to His Majesty in appreciation of his support to the ATO, which resulted in making numerous achievements that serve tourism at both the regional and local levels. The ATO president delivered a speech in which he stated that the award comes in appreciation of His Majesty's contribution to tourism and his support to the organization and its goals since its establishment through joint cooperation with Bahrain Tourism and Exhibition Authority, as well as on the occasion of Manama being selected the Arab Capital of Tourism in 2013. His Majesty welcomed the ATO President and the accompanying delegation, expressing thanks and appreciation for the medal, which also reflects the appreciation of the continuous efforts of Bahrain to develop the tourism sector as a major contributor to the national economy. His Majesty noted that the Kingdom's civilization and cultural assets have made it a leading destination for global tourism. His Majesty praised the cooperation between the Ministry of Industry, Commerce and Tourism and Bahrain Tourism and Exhibition Authority, affirming that the Kingdom will implement major projects in cooperation with the ATO. He noted the Arab world's touristic and natural assets and the historical monuments testify to its ancient history, which makes it a leading touristic destination. His Majesty praised the achievements of the ATO and its role in developing joint Arab action in the field of tourism. He wished the President of the ATO and its affiliates further success and progress. For his part, the ATO President expressed thanks and appreciation to His Majesty the King for his keenness on developing joint cooperation between the Kingdom and the organization. He praised the progress of Bahrain in the prosperous era of His Majesty the King. He also praised the leading touristic achievements and its provision of outstanding services and infrastructure for tourists and investors in the field of tourism. His Majesty King Hamad bin Isa Al Khalifa received today at Sakhir Palace the personal representative of His Majesty the King for Charity Work in Youth Affairs, Chairman of the Supreme Council for Youth and Sports, President of Bahrain Olympic Committee, His Highness Sheikh Nasser bin Hamad Al Khalifa, who presented to His Majesty the winners of the King Hamad Award for empowering youth to achieve sustainable development goals.
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. سيدي حضرة صاحب الجلالة الملك حمد بن عيسى الخليفة.
The meeting commenced with the recitation of the Holy Quran.
أصحاب السمو، أصحاب المعالي والسعادة، أيها السيدات والسادة، السلام عليكم ورحمة الله تعالى وبركاته. خير ما نبدأ به تلاوة عطرة من القرآن الكريم يتلوها على مسامعنا القارئ خالد عبد الرحمن الرئيس.
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما. إنا عرضنا الأمانة على السماوات والأرض والجبال فأبين أن يحملنها وأشفقن منها وحملها الإنسان إنه كان ظلوما جهولا. ليعذب الله المنافقين والمنافقات والمشركين والمشركات ويتوب الله على المؤمنين والمؤمنات وكان الله غفورا رحيما. صدق الله العظيم.
يتفضل سيدي حضرة صاحب الجلالة الملك حمد بن عيسى.
His Majesty the King then delivered the following speech.
بإلقاء كلمة بهذه المناسبة.
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. نرحب بكم أجمل ترحيب، ويسعدنا أن نشهد معكم اليوم نتائج المشاركة في أعمال الجائزة التي نعتز برعايتها لما تحمله من تطلعات وأمال نتشارك فيها مع المجتمع الدولي لبلوغ الأهداف التنموية المستدامة من أجل عالم أفضل حيث يتمتع الجميع بحق العيش في سلام ورخاء ونماء. كما تأتي الجائزة بأهدافها النوعية لتعبر عن قناعتنا الراسخة بأهمية الدور الذي يجب أن يتولاه الشباب في صياغة مستقبلهم وإشراكهم في برامج التنمية والتطوير لاستيعاب تطلعاتهم وإعدادهم الإعداد السليم لأداء واجباتهم اتجاه أوطانهم بشكل مسؤول وبما يمكنهم من وضع أسس وملامح ذلك المستقبل المشرق. ونود بهذه المناسبة أن نهنئ الفائزين بالجائزة في كافة فئاتها من أفراد ومؤسسات حكومية وخاصة وأهلية، ونحيي لهم جهودهم في رفعة وتمكين الشباب من منطلق إيمانهم بدورهم الريادي في بناء أوطانهم والنهوض بمجتمعاتهم. ولا يسعنا كذلك إلا أن نشكر الإبن العزيز سمو الشيخ ناصر بن حمد آل خليفة ممثلنا الشخصي للأعمال الخيرية وشؤون الشباب، على إشرافه المباشر على أعمال هذه المبادرة الدولية، والشكر كذلك لهيئات الأمم المتحدة المعنية ولوزارة الشباب والرياضة وأعضاء لجان التحكيم على جهودهم الكريمة لتحقيق الأهداف النبيلة للجائزة. والسلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.
كلمة يلقيها سمو الشيخ ناصر بن حمد آل خليفة الممثل
الشخصي. Then الشيخ ناصر delivered the following speech.
للأعمال الخيرية وشؤون الشباب.
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. سيدي حضرة صاحب الجلالة الملك حمد بن عيسى آل خليفة عاهل البلاد المفدى، حفظكم الله ورعاكم. حضورنا الكريم، السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. يطيب لي يا صاحب الجلالة أن أتقدم لجلالتكم بخالص الشكر وعظيم الامتنان على ما تقدمونه من دعم ومساندة واضحة للشباب البحريني والعالمي في مختلف المجالات، حتى باتت شريحة الشباب في كل العالم تحتل أولوية بارزة في فكر جلالتكم النير ونظرتكم المستقبلية والثاقبة واستشرافكم لدورهم الهام والمؤثر في عملية التنمية المستدامة باعتبارهم الثروة الحقيقية والمحرك لكافة عملية التطور والنماء. سيدي، لقد كان لمبادرات جلالتكم الرائدة والأولى من نوعها عالمياً تجاه الشباب من خلال إطلاق جائزة جلالتكم لتمكين الشباب لتحقيق أهداف التنمية المستدامة صداها إيجابي على مستوى العالم، وحثت الدول والمؤسسات الحكومية والخاصة لتوجيه الأنظار والدعم إلى الشباب لتمكينهم في تحقيق أهداف التنمية المستدامة التي أقرتها الأمم المتحدة واعتمدها قادة العالم في سبتمبر 2015 في قمة أممية تاريخية. ولقد لمسنا هذا النجاح وهذا الانتشار الواسع من خلال وصول عدد المشاركين في النسخة الأولى من الجائزة إلى 663 مشارك من 87 دولة مختلفة، لتعكس هذه المشاركة الكبيرة الأهداف النبيلة التي تحملها الجائزة ومردودها الإيجابي على مسيرة الارتقاء بمنظومة العمل في تلك البلدان والدور المرتقب من دور الشباب في تحقيق أهداف التنمية المستدامة لتشق طريقها السليم نحو البناء والتطور وإحلال التنمية المستدامة. سيدي، إننا نعاهد جلالتكم أن نمضي قدماً في دعم الشباب وتقديم المبادرات العالمية الرائدة في مجالات تمكين الشباب، وأن تكون النسخة الثانية من جائزة جلالتكم إن شاء الله نسخة ناجحة بكافة المقاييس تستقطب أكبر شريحة من الشباب من مختلف دول العالم، وأن نعزز من المكانة الرائدة التي حققتها مملكة البحرين عالمياً في تبنيها للعديد من قضايا الشباب حتى أصبحنا عاصمة عالمية للشباب. وسيستمر البناء ما تحقق من إنجازات والعمل على تعزيز آليات الشراكات مع الجميع لمواكبة المتطلبات والاحتياجات، حيث سيشكل الوفاء بالتزاماتنا الدولية والمتضامنة على الصعيد العالمي انطلاقة حقيقية لبلوغ أهداف التنمية المستدامة. ختاماً يا صاحب الجلالة، نؤكد لجلالتكم أن مملكة البحرين حرصت على تحمل مسؤولياتها الإقليمية والدولية تجاه تحقيق إشراك الشباب في تحقيق أهداف التنمية المستدامة بمختلف أبعادها، وقطعنا شوطاً كبيراً في تنفيذ المبادرات السامية لجلالتكم للنهوض بالشراكة الدولية والتي تأتي معززة لدور البحريني المتواصل من العمل الإنمائي. وفي هذه المناسبة أود أن أتقدم بالشكر والتقدير إلى وزارة الخارجية ووزارة شؤون الشباب والرياضة والمجلس الاقتصادي الاجتماعي بالأمم المتحدة وبرنامج الأمم المتحدة الإنمائي في مملكة البحرين، وإلى أعضاء لجنة التحكيم العليا والأولوية على تعاونهم الوثيق والذي ساهم في إنجاح هذه المبادرة. والسلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.
الحضور الكريم، يلقي سعادة السيد أمين الشرقاوي ممثل الأمم المتحدة لدى مملكة البحرين هذه الكلمة.
Then the United Nations Resident Coordinator and Resident Representative Amin al-Sharqawi delivered a speech in which he expressed pride in meeting His Majesty the King. He stated that the award embodies a progressive idea of development and is a confirmation of what is stated in the Bahrain National Action Charter of the Kingdom regarding the development of youth. He added that the award and the work on youth and sustainable development in general are an integral part of the strategic partnership framework. Al-Sharqawi also stated that the process behind the award was built on transparency and objectivity, a result of the appointment of an international team of award jurors from the United Nations, as well as the adoption of impartial selection criteria and a state-of-the-art electronic system for the selection process. He affirmed that at the United Nations, the members aspire to open new doors of opportunity for cooperation with the Kingdom of Bahrain on pioneering initiatives to achieve the sustainable development goals and provide support to His Majesty the King, the representative of His Majesty the King for Charity Work and Youth Affairs, Chairman of the Supreme Council for Youth and Sports and President of Bahrain Olympic Committee, His Honor Sheikh Nasser bin Hamad Al Khalifa, and the Ministry of Youth and Sports Affairs. Reiterated his congratulations to His Majesty the King on the great initiative in which the United Nations have been honored to take part.
فهي تعكس مستوى عاليا من الوعي والفكر الثاقب من لدنكم كما تعكس الالتزام تجاه دور مملكة البحرين في تحقيق أهداف التنمية المستدامة والتي يسعدنا في الأمم المتحدة أن نتشارك معها على تحقيقه ولذلك فإن هذه الجائزة القيمة تجسد دون شك فكرا تنمويا بارذا لافتا الجميع الأنظار لافتا لجميع الأنظار حول العالم فمن جهة تأتي تأكيدا لما جاء في ميثاق العمل الوطني البحريني الذي توافقت عليه غالبية الشعب البحريني لما فيه من حكمة وبعد نظر وفي هذا السياق ما يفيد عناية الدولة بشكل خاص بنمو الشباب العقلي والبدني والخلقي ومراعاة الأسس الاقتصادية للمجتمع القائمة على مبدأ الحرية الاقتصادية والعدالة وتنويع النشاط الاقتصادي ومصادر الدخل والاستغلال الأمثل للموارد والثروات الطبيعية وصيانة الأموال العامة وهو ما جعل البحرين تحقق مستوى متقدما في التنمية الاقتصادية ومن جهة ثانية فإن تبني مملكة البحرين لأهداف التنمية المستدامة 17 واعتمادها في خطة عمل حكومتها للأعوام المقبلة إلى جانب رؤيتها الاقتصادية 2030 التي تتقاطع في كثير من حيثياتها مع أجندة التنمية المستدامة كل ذلك يشير أن مملكة البحرين ماضية بكل قوة وإرادة لتحقيق أهداف التنمية المستدامة دون تخلف أحد عن الركب صاحب الجلالة إن هذه الجائزة النوعية والسباقة عالمياً واللي يأتي تنفيذها ضمن إطار الشراكة الاستراتيجية بين مملكة البحرين والأمم المتحدة التي وقعت في 24 من أكتوبر الماضي للأعوام 2018-2022 والتي توخى اختيار أفضل المشاريع الشبابية التي تخاطب أهداف التنمية المستدامة قد بدأت اليوم تسير بفضل رؤيتكم السديدة والجهود المشتركة في المسار الصحيح وتحقيق الأهداف المنشودة التي أقيمت لأجلها ولعل انفتاح هذه الجائزة على جميع الدول بمؤسساتها العامة والخاصة والمدنية وغير الربحية إلى جانب الأفراد هو الذي أعطاها هذا التجاوب الدولي الكبير واسمحوا لنا على عجالة أن نكشف هذه الإحصاءات المتعلقة بالجائزة فقد بلغ العدد الإجمالي للمشاركة 800 مشارك وصل منها إلى التحكيم 663 مشاركة قُبل منها 602 وذلك من 87 دولة حول العالم تصدر هذه المشاركات الأفراد ب 448 مشاركة ثلاثة من المؤسسات غير الربحية ب 111 مشاركة ثم المؤسسات الحكومية وأخيراً الشركات الخاصة إن عدد المشاركات يعد كبيراً نسبياً وهو المرشح للزيادة في الأعوام القادمة ولا سيما إنه تم اختيار فريق أممي دولي من المحكمين لتحكيم الجائزة إلى جانب استحداث النظام الإلكتروني لترشيد التقديم، وهو ما يضمن توافر عنصري الشفافية والمصداقية، كما يحقق السمعة اللائقة بهذه الجائزة الفريدة. إن تمكين وإدماج كل الشباب حول العالم يعد عاملاً مهماً وأساسياً في المجتمعات، نظراً إلى أن الشباب هم المسؤولين عن تطورها وتقدمها، سواء كرواد أعمال أم نشطاء، إنهم قادة التغيير وملهميه بما يمتلكونه من مواهب وطاقات وأفكار ورؤى. وإن الآمال معقودة على هذه الأجيال الشابة، غير أننا في الوقت ذاته يجب أن نكون حريصين على الاستثمار الأمثل في الشباب، وإن على الحكومات أن تعمل معهم وتأخذ بأيديهم نحو تحقيق أهداف التنمية المستدامة. إن مملكة البحرين تضم ما يقارب 60% من الشباب تحت 30 عام، وهي بفضل توجيهات جلالتكم تعد مثالاً بارزاً على الاهتمام بالشباب وإشراكهم. يتمثل ذلك في مبادرتها المختلفة من قبيل مدينة الشباب والمؤتمر الدولي للشباب وأهداف التنمية المستدامة، وتطويرها للمراكز والأندية الشبابية في مختلف أنحاء المملكة. وأخيراً، فإننا نتطلع في الأمم المتحدة إلى فتح مزيد من آفاق التعاون مع مملكة البحرين، ومزيد من المبادرات الرائدة لإنجاز أكبر قدر من غايات أهداف التنمية المستدامة، وذلك بمساندة ودعم من جلالتكم ثم من سمو الشيخ ناصر بن حمد الخليفة، إلى جانب وزارة الشباب والرياضة بقيادتها النشيطة وفريق العمل لديهم. صاحب الجلالة، مجدداً نتقدم إليكم بخالص التهنئة على هذه المبادرة المتميزة، والتي يسعدنا في الأمم المتحدة أن نكون جزء منها. إن مملكة البحرين مثال حي على التعايش السلمي والانفتاح. إنها صغيرة في حجمها، كبيرة بإنجازاتها، ولا سيما يتعلق بالتنمية البشرية بفضل حكمة قادتها وجهود شعبها. وقبل أن أختم، اسمح لي يا صاحب الجلالة أن أشارككم بعضاً من الشعر الذي أعجبني. اسمح لي أخرج برا الرسميات. وجدت هذا الشعر أهلاً لكم. أحمد شوقي قال: شيدت صرحاً للذخائر عالياً، يأوى الجمال إليه والإلهام، بلغ البناء على يدك تمامه، ولكل ما تبني يداك تمام. وفي برضو شاعر بحريني قال: حمد، سعيت لخير شعبك مخلصا، ولهم فتحت إلى التقدم بابا، فحباك حلما والأناتة وحكمة، جاءت فعالك والمقال ثوابا، فما قصرت عن العلياء كف، تطاول عن عزائمها البناء، بعزمك كل معضلة ستخبو، وبالإيمان يزدهر النماء. شكرا.
كلمة الفائزين بجائزة الملك حمد لتمكين الشباب تلقيها نيابة عنهم.
On behalf of the award winners, Ms. Hadia Ali Shirazi gave the following speech.
Your Majesty King Hamad bin Isa Al Khalifa, King of Bahrain, peace, mercy and blessings of Allah may be upon you. It is a great honor for me to stand here before your Majesty on this special occasion, which we are proud of. This celebration that brings us together with a leader who understands and believes in the importance of the active role played by young people in leading the world towards broad horizons of development and giving them the full opportunity to unleash their bright ideas and innovation to be the basis for the development of the world and the various components of sustainable development in it. Your Majesty, on this day, we bring to you a message of thanks and appreciation from the youth of the world, and I have the honor to speak on their behalf. Please allow me to express our sincere gratitude for your initiative to empower young people to achieve the Sustainable Development Goals, an initiative which is the first of its kind on a global level. These initiatives were launched by your illustrious kingdom, which showed its clear interest in the youth of the world and realized its importance and realized its responsibilities towards the youth, and was able to achieve an important international consensus, making this award widely spread because of its noble goals towards youth and the countries of the world. Your Majesty, we are proud to have participated in Your Majesty's award to empower young people to achieve the Sustainable Development Goals. This award has provided us with a real and ideal opportunity to spread our creativity, ideas, and innovation towards achieving the goals of sustainable development, and to send a clear message to all officials in our countries that we are going to lead the world, and we are ready to participate in the development of its bright future, and to let our ideas achieve the Sustainable Development Goals. Your Majesty, in the end, we would like to thank you once again for honoring us after our participation in Your Majesty's award to empower young people to achieve the Sustainable Development Goals. And we highly value and appreciate Your Majesty's keenness to support the youth of the world. Thank you.
After that, His Majesty the King awarded the winners, and they are Ms. Hadia Ali Shirazi of the Islamic Republic of Pakistan, who has worked on a range of initiatives to achieve the goals of sustainable development. The winner from the private sector, the Gulf Petrochemical Industry Company, GPIC, which contributed to four indicators through education and training programs and environmental lectures. The award was received by GPIC's president, Dr. Abdurrahman Jawahari. The winner from the government sector, the Youth Foundation of the President of the Republic of Azerbaijan, which supports innovative ideas for youth. The award was received by the Chief of Staff of the Youth Foundation of the President of Azerbaijan, Mr. Fayyaz Gorbatov. The winner from the category of NGOs and international organizations, the Youth Organization for Development from the Republic of Sierra Leone, which aims to empower young people in many fields. The award was received by the organization's coordinator of development programs, Mr. Othman Sharif. His Majesty the King then honored the members of the Supreme Judging Committee, which consists of the Minister of Youth and Sports of the Arab Republic of Egypt, Engineer Khalid Mahmoud Abdulaziz, Minister of Youth of the United Arab Emirates, Shamma bint Sahel Mazrui. His Majesty also honored the members of the first jury that consists of the director of the UNDP Regional Innovations Team in the Arab States, Ms. Jennifer Colleyville, director of UNDP's World Youth Program, Ms. Noelle Richard, UNDP Development Program Analyst in the Kingdom of Bahrain, Mr. Ali Salman Saleh, and the Regional Advisor for UNDP in the Arab States, Namana Sayed. His Majesty the King was then presented with a commemorative gift. Then the United Nations Resident Coordinator and Resident Representative Amin Sharqawi delivered a speech in which he expressed pride in meeting His Majesty the King. His Majesty King Hamad bin Isa Al Khalifa received today at Sakhir Palace, the United Arab Emirates, the UAE Minister of Culture and Knowledge Development, Noura bint Mohammed Al Kabi, and the Minister of Youth, Shamma bint Sahel Al Mazrui, on the occasion of their visit to the kingdom to participate in the King Hamad Award for empowering youth to achieve sustainable development goals. The two ministers conveyed the greetings of the UAE President, Sheikh Khalifa bin Zayed Al Nahyan, and the Deputy Vice President, Prime Minister and ruler of Dubai, Sheikh Mohammed bin Rashid Al Khalifa, and the Crown Prince of Abu Dhabi, Deputy Supreme Commander of the UAE Armed Forces, Sheikh Mohammed bin Zayed Al Nahyan, and their wishes of abundant health and happiness to His Majesty the King and further progress and prosperity to the kingdom. His Majesty affirmed the deep-rooted historic relations between Bahrain and the UAE and the development joint cooperation on all levels, expressing pride in the fraternal ties and the development they witness. They thanked His Majesty for participating in the ceremony, affirming youth and cultural cooperation and joint coordination between the two countries to achieve the common interests and goals. Noura bint Mohammed Al-Kabi and Shamma bint Sahel Al-Mazrui expressed thanks and appreciation to His Majesty the King for supporting cooperation between the two countries, hailing the existing cooperation between the two countries in the cultural and youth fields. His Majesty King Hamad bin Isa Al Khalifa sent a cable of congratulations to the first Deputy Chairman of the Supreme Council for Youth and Sports and President of Bahrain Athletics Association, His Honor Sheikh Khalid bin Hamad Al Khalifa, for ranking third place in the lightweight class of the Bahraini Strongest Man Championship. In the cable, His Majesty the King praised His Honor Sheikh Khalid's role and contributions to the success of the championship and his supervision of the High Organizing Committee and the Working Committee, which culminated in the success of the championship. His Majesty also sent a congratulatory cable to Captain Sheikh Abdullah bin Khalifa bin Ahmed Al Khalifa on winning first place in the middleweight class of Bahraini Strongest Man Championship, lauding his excellent level and fitness as well as persistence, wishing him success in upcoming championships. His Majesty also sent congratulatory cable to Imad Hussein Al Ghaffas on winning first place in the heavyweight class of Bahraini Strongest Man Championship, lauding his excellent level and wishing him success in upcoming championships. His Royal Highness the Prime Minister Prince Khalifa bin Salman Al Khalifa also sent a cable of congratulations to the first Deputy Chairman of the Supreme Council for Youth and Sports and President of Bahrain Athletics Association, His Honor Sheikh Khalid bin Hamad Al Khalifa, for ranking third in the lightweight class of the Bahraini Strongest Man Championship and the success of the event. His Royal Highness hailed His Honor Sheikh Khalid's achievements and expressed pride in the determinations of His Highness and Bahraini youth to promote Bahrain in various sporting events. His Royal Highness Prime Minister Prince Khalifa bin Salman Al Khalifa met today at Qutaybiyah Palace with a number of Muharraq citizens. He affirmed that the kingdom, under the leadership of His Majesty King Hamad bin Isa Al Khalifa, will continue to make achievements that benefit the people of Bahrain and grant them security and stability. His Royal Highness added that the misuse of social media is considered cyber terrorism and that it must be stopped. He added that the Bahraini community rejects the exploitation of social media for the purpose of disrupting social cohesion and spreading chaos. His Royal Highness emphasized that the kingdom continues to create an environment of coexistence to stand in the face of sedition and division. The Prime Minister hailed the rich history of Muharraq, adding that its honorable stances, along with that of their brothers in the other regions of the kingdom, have foiled the attempts to disrupt national cohesion. His Royal Highness noted that the people of Muharraq serve as an excellent example of patriotism and loyalty. He expressed the pleasure in meeting with the people of Muharraq, noting his keenness on listening to their concerns and opinions regarding their governorate status in the fields of health, education, housing and infrastructure. The premier underscored keenness to communicate with all the people of Bahrain to strengthen the national fabric and promote unity. He called on the people to instill the values of cohesion and unity in future generations to safeguard them against all attempts of division. He stated that the unprecedented challenges that face the region call for awareness against the plotted schemes that aim to stir chaos, to maintain the nation's security and stability, and continue its development and progress.
Thank you.
For his part, Dr. Mohammed Hassan Kamal al-Din delivered a speech on behalf of the people of Muharraq, in which he expressed the thanks and appreciation of the people to His Royal Highness for his follow-up on the needs of Muharraq and for his efforts to further develop the area. He hailed His Royal Highness's national stances and his eminent role in the development of the kingdom, as well as his efforts to defend the causes of Bahrain and meet the aspirations of people. Dr. Kamal al-Din praised His Royal Highness's directives regarding the misuse of social media. He recalled the Premier's honorable stances in 2011, wishing him abundant health and happiness.
البحرين الحديثة وراعي تقدمها وحامي عزتها واستقرارها، وكنت على الدوام سيدي وستبقى في مقدمة الركب. كنت أنت يوم كانت القضية عروبة البحرين، وكنت أنت يوم تهدد أمنها واستقرارها، وقد كنت أنت دائما بمواقفك الحكيمة الحاسمة في كافة قضايا البحرين المفصلية في تاريخها الحديث. تغانم يا وجه الخير يا البحر.
During the meeting, poet Salem Ahmed Al-Manna'i recited a poem praising His Royal Highness's stances and his role in developing the kingdom.
بشوفك تقر عياننا والنفوس تزين من محرق وفرجانها صاغت الديفان. مشاعر مثل كفين وإحساس مثل أمين بذوق وبساطة فاحت صدورنا ريحان على الطيبة وروح الأخوة بذرنا سنين كتب ربي إن يهدي سبأ هدهد سليمان وليت إن يهدي روحي لديرة البحرين كتب ربي إن يهدي سبأ هدهد سليمان وليتني يهدي روحي لديرة البحرين لها لون ذوق المر ونخاوي الحرمان تركنا مضاجعنا وجينا لها ملبين جبل طور صم اسمه خليفة بن سلمان ولا هزت في الأعوام.
His Royal Highness the Prime Minister Prince Khalifa bin Salman Al Khalifa received today at Ghalibia Palace a number of royal family members, officials, businessmen, journalists, media personnel and citizens. His Royal Highness affirmed that the people of Bahrain's loyalty is to the leadership is acclaimed and its unification protected the kingdom and preserved its unity. He added that the kingdom will overcome old practices that incite division and hatred between people and it will not allow social media to become a platform for damaging people's reputations. His Royal Highness hailed the Council of Representatives and its members, affirming his respect and support to the representatives of citizens. The Prime Minister asserted his follow-up on citizens and their needs, urging to take advantage of modern technology, communication to enhance national unity and serve development process. His Royal Highness expressed pleasure in the contribution of citizens, columnists and civil society organizations to warning against the negative effects of misusing social media websites, stressing that their contributions reflect Bahraini people's ethics and values. His Royal Highness discussed the upcoming elections in Bahrain Chamber of Commerce and Industry, the BCCI, wishing the Traders House success in the elections. He added that the BCCI had contributed to the commerce movement in the kingdom. He affirmed the government's keenness on supporting BCCI to ensure providing an atmosphere of openness and flexibility in order to achieve the aspirations of its members. His Royal Highness the Crown Prince Deputy Supreme Commander and First Deputy Prime Minister Prince Salman bin Hamad Al Khalifa sent a cable of congratulations to the First Deputy Chairman of the Supreme Council for Youth and Sports and President of Bahrain Athletics Association, His Honour Sheikh Khalid bin Hamad Al Khalifa, for ranking the third in the lightweight class of the Bahraini Strongest Man Championship and the success of the event. His Royal Highness hailed the role of His Highness in aiding the success of the championship and supporting and patronizing it. His Royal Highness affirmed that the success of the championship success contributed in highlighting the youth's competencies, noting His Highness's role in organizing various events. His Royal Highness the Crown Prince sent similar cables to Captain Sheikh Abdullah bin Khalifa bin Ahmed Al Khalifa on winning first place in the middleweight class of Bahraini Strongest Man Championship, and to Ahmad Hussein Al Ghaffaz on winning first place in the heavyweight class of Bahraini Strongest Man Championship, lauding his excellent level and wishing him success in upcoming championships. The Royal Court Minister Sheikh Khalid bin Ahmed Al Khalifa sent a cable congratulations to the First Deputy Chairman of the Supreme Council for Youth and Sports and President of Bahrain's Athletics Association, His Honour Sheikh Khalid bin Hamad Al Khalifa, for ranking third in the lightweight class of the Bahraini Strongest Man Championship. The Royal Court Minister hailed the success of the two-day championship, which concluded yesterday in Bahrain, commending His Highness Sheikh Khalid bin Hamad Al Khalifa for his efforts to ensure the success of the championship and his honorable performance. He also sent a cable of congratulations to East Rifat Chairman Captain Sheikh Abdullah bin Khalifa bin Ahmed Al Khalifa for ranking first in the middleweight class in the championship. He commended his achievements and determination, setting a role model for Bahrainis to honor their country in all sporting championships. Royal Courts Minister also sent a congratulatory cable to Ahmad Hussein Al Ghaffaz on winning the first place ranking in the heavyweight class of the championship. The minister wished Ahmad Al Ghaffaz more success in upcoming championships. The Shura Council held its weekly session today, presided by its chairman, Ali bin Salah al-Salah. The council completed discussing the second supplementary report of the Foreign Affairs, Defense and National Security Committee. It rejected a draft law suggested by the Women and Children's Affairs Committee to amend certain provisions of the Child's Law and rejected the draft law of the Public Utilities and Environment Affairs Committee. The council approved the proposal to allocate the next session to review their strategic plan for implementation of the National Plan for the Advancement of Bahraini Women and the role of the legislative project prepared by the Supreme Council for Women and approved by His Majesty the King. Interior Minister Lieutenant General Sheikh Rashid bin Abdullah Al Khalifa attended today the concluding ceremony of the Ministry of Interior's Olympic Shooting Championship in the presence of the Governor of the Southern Province, Sheikh Khalifa bin Ali Al Khalifa, President of the Bahrain Shooting Association, Sheikh Salman bin Khalid Al Khalifa, Chief of Public Security, and the Undersecretary of the Ministry of Interior. The minister and the attendees inspected the shooting ranges and the preparations alongside weapons and special equipment for the shooting teams. The minister witnessed the part of the final match, where he praised the outstanding skills and high level of the championship as well as the competency shown by shooters. He expressed thanks and appreciation to the president of the Bahrain Shooting Association for his role in aiding the success of the championship and continuous cooperation and coordination with the Public Security Sports Association. For his part, the president of the Public Security Sports Association, Colonel Khalid Abdulaziz Al Khayyat, affirmed that thanks to the directives and keenness of the Interior Minister to implement advanced preparation programs and the follow-up of the Chief of Public Security, the ministry had reinforced the culture of sports to all its affiliates. He added that the association has exerted many efforts to implement the plan of the Interior Ministry to develop the sports field according to high-quality training programs supervised by experienced trainers that contribute in developing the competency of the association's teams. The Interior Minister and the Shooting Association President honored the winners in the four competitions for guns, pistols, shotguns, and bow and arrows. The championship was organized by the Public Security Sports Association in cooperation with the Bahrain Shooting Association from February the 19th until the 25th, with the participation of the Bahrain Defense Force and the National Guard.